Sometimes I'm afraid that we don't do enough stuff on this channel for the real beginners. You know, basic stuff. For guys that are just trying to pick up the mysteries of these archaic but cool devices that we use on these classic cars. Carburetors, right? The basic tuning, the basic setup of these things. So the other night, I'm flipping through YouTube and I'm watching one of these revival videos. And it's a younger guy, he's like in his mid-30s, early 30s. And he gets the car running. And then once it's started, he takes a screwdriver and he starts going around the carburetor. He's just like turning every screw he can get his thing on. And he's like twirling away and just going back and forth. What are you trying to get a genie to pop out of the top of this thing? Just no rhyme or reason. What are you trying to accomplish? And then it dawned on me. It's like, this guy's only like in his early 30s. Carburetors were gone from regular production cars before this guy was even born. Nobody's born with the knowledge. No, how is he supposed to know all of the ins and outs of setting up, dialing a carburetor? This is like it's a mystery thing to these younger people. So I figured let's do a quick video on basic carburetor setup and adjust. And I tell you, it's more universal than most people think. And here's trivia for you. Have you ever wondered why carburetor, idle, mixture screws are always flatheads? Right? You ever wonder about that? They're never Phillips. They're never like Torx or any other weird fastener or anything like that. They're always flatheads. You'll see in a few minutes. So, carburetor, idle, and adjust. Here's what you need to know. Before you could get any other basic tune on a car, before you could think about jetting or making changes or improving or even just getting a tune-up, a well-functional car, well-functioning car, you have to have a clean, smooth idle. And the procedure for doing this is like fairly universal. Carburetor designers for the cars that we deal with, American cars, the carburetor designers, engineers, put certain proportions of adjustment in their carburetors that are fairly universal. So this way, the average guy, the average mechanic, can bounce from car to car, from carburetor to carburetor, and make similar adjustments on each one and achieve similar results. So because of that, all of the various types of carburetors that we deal with, these Carter, Edelbrock, AFB, AVS, and like thermoquad type of carburetors are all set up very similar as far as proportions go. On these, you've got your throttle stop screw here and your idle mixture screws here. Holley's will have approximately the same adjustment range. And here, your throttle stop screw is here facing the back, and your idle mixture screws on either side of the metering block. Right now, some double pumper Holleys are what they call four corner, and they'll have a set of idle mixture screws in the secondary metering block. We're not really going to get into that, but if you can master the front half, you can do the back half too. It's not a big deal. And then you've got the more pedestrian carburetors, like the Rochester two barrels or this Carter BBD, which we're going to use because it's the lightest of the bunch. It's easiest to handle. So this is the one we'll use to demonstrate. All of the setup on these things is fairly universal. All of the proportions are fairly similar, okay? Or actually very similar. You set one up, you can set them all up. So here's what you need to know about a carburetor. Carburetor has three basic circuits, okay? You've got the idle circuit, the one that you're gonna adjust, and that's through these two screws, okay? And then you've got an intermediate circuit, a transfer slot. And if I open the throttle blades, I don't know if you can see it, but there is a slot. See a slot, it's about a quarter of an inch. Can you see that? The lighting here is terrible. It's about a quarter of an inch long. Right? When I close the throttle blade, it disappears. Okay? So that's where it pulls fuel once the throttle blades are just partially open, but not open enough to pull air through the boosters. The boosters are the main circuit. So when the throttle blades are open about yay much or so, it's pulling air and fuel through the boosters, and that's where the main jets and all of that comes in. So the idle mixture is your first step. It's your first tuning step. It's the only part of it that can be externally tuned. And you can't get a clean tune on any other part of it until you've established a good idle. So, as I said, they're all basically universal. And your setup begins like this. What you want to do is you want to take your throttle stop screw and you want to turn it all the way out until it's not contacting the stop. So basically, the throttle is completely closed. No contact at the screw. Now, turn the screw in 1.5 turns. And here's where the flats come in. This is why these are all flats. Because from a visual perspective, from a tuning perspective, it's easy to keep track of how many turns you go. So here's half turn, full turn, turn and a half. Okay? Oh, I didn't do that on camera. I'm terrible with this. All right, I'll show you on this one. So on the idle mixture screws, okay, you're gonna turn them all the way in. Now when you turn these in, let me use a bigger screwdriver. When you turn these in, you don't wanna force them, okay? You wanna get them to just where they just wanna stop. Okay, just what is resistance. If you force it close, if you push a little bit past that resistance, you can distort the metal around the needle. Right, so, and just in case you guys have not seen what the needle looks like, here's your idle screw, and that's what the needle looks like. And that's your actual fuel metering device, that needle right there. How much fuel can get past the tip of that. All right. So you want to turn the screws, you want to turn these screws all the way in, okay, until they just barely seat. Now come out 1.5 turns. So there's half turn, full turn, 1.5 turns. All right, and do the same thing on the other side. All the way in until it just, you feel the resistance, okay? And then come out 1.5 turns. So there's a half, there's 1.5. Now you're ready to start the engine. So what you're trying to achieve here is the highest, smoothest idle given the position of the throttle stop. You put this carburetor on a 300 cubic inch engine, it's gonna have this stop position is gonna have a different effect than it would have on a 400 cubic inch engine, right? So you've got your 1.5 turns in on the throttle stop. You start your engine. So let's just say now we want to achieve approximately an 800 RPM idle. What we're going to do is we're going to bring the throttle stop screw in or out until we achieve that 800 RPM or thereabouts. Get close to it because it's just your initial tune. Now here's what you need to know. If you've come out a turn and a half on your initial setup, you start the car, but it will not idle. Okay, and you have to go, let's say, two turns or three turns before you can get the engine to idle. It means that you've got a problem. You've got a clogged idle passage inside the carburetor. What that means is that in order for the engine to get enough fuel to idle, you have to be into the transfer slot, and it's not supposed to see the transfer slot until you're actually on the throttle, until you're starting to accelerate. So, if you've got to go past that 1.5 turns on the throttle stop screw to get this thing to idle in the 800,000 RPM range, you've got a problem. Just stop right there, right? Fix your carburetor. You'll want to find the highest, smoothest RPM. The old timer way to do it is with a vacuum gauge, right? What you do is you hook the vacuum gauge to manifold vacuum and you tune the carburetor, you change the idle mixture screws, you work with the idle mixture screws until you get the highest vacuum. The highest vacuum would equate to the highest idle given the throttle position, right? Where you've got the throttle stop set. Or you could use a tack. You hook up a tack and just as you turn your mixture screws, you watch the tack and you get your highest RPM, that's it. If you're working where you don't have a vacuum gauge or you don't have a tack handy and you're just trying to get a quick tune up on the car, it it doesn't have to be that precise. You'll know by ear, you'll know by sense when you've reached the highest, smoothest idle, right? Just go slow and pay attention. You don't really need a gauge or a meter to tell you where it's right. You'll pick it up, you'll feel it, you'll see it, sense it. All right, so now we've got our engine idling. We're around 800 RPM or whatever, wherever it is that you want to set yours, but let's just use 800 RPM as the number. Okay, so our idle is set. Now remember, we have the idle mixture screws turned out 1.5 turns each. Your first step is to start turning them back in. So what you'll do is take your first screw, go half a turn in, right? Did the RPM start to drop? No. Go to the other side, turn it half a turn in. Did the RPM start to drop? No. Go back to your first screw, start to turn it in. At some point, you're gonna feel the RPM start to drop. When you do, stop and go back to your last position. And again, see, that's why that flat is important, because a flat lets you keep track of your last position. Do the same on the other side. All right, so now you've found the leanest that this thing will idle. As you're screwing them in, as you're putting them in, you're finding, you're reducing the amount of fuel, and you've just found the leanest where this thing will idle. So now start going the other way. Come out half a turn. Did the RPM come up? Yes. Okay, go to the next side. Turn it out half a turn. Did the RPM come up? Yes. Okay, go back to the first one. Now at some point, when you start turning them out, you're not gonna find a difference. And that's where you wanna stop. Balance out the screws. So basically, you wanna go in until there's lean, until you find lean. Stop, and then start working your way out. And when you work your way out, find the highest speed. When you find the highest speed, stop. And there's your basic adjustment. Some guys will want to split hairs. They'll go like a quarter turn and they're looking for exactly the razor's edge of lean. Or don't do that with a carburetor. Carburetors work on averages. The mixture adjustment that you make at lunchtime when it's 80 degrees is going to be off that night when the sun goes down and it's 50 degrees. Don't try, that's the job of fuel injection. Fuel injection works the way it does. It is as efficient as it is because it's constantly making adjustments based on atmospheric conditions. It's constantly making those mixture adjustments on the fly. Carburetor doesn't do that. So what you want to do is you want to split, you want to find the best average. What I usually do is once I've brought the two screws out and I've balanced them to where I've got the highest RPM, what I'll generally do at that point is go another quarter, okay? So you bring it out, you count your flats, make sure your flats are like this, and when you find that highest RPM, come out another quarter. You can even come out another half. And what that'll do is that'll compensate for the difference between the adjustment that you're making when it's bright and sunny and hot and everything else, and then at night, the sun goes down, the air gets dense, the fuel mixture, the fuel requirement changes. Going that little extra half guarantees that you're balanced. You're gonna be balanced. Don't try to go to the razor's edge with a carburetor. Just shoot for the best average and it'll be happy. And like I said, you can't do anything else. You can't make any other adjustments or even make any judgments, really, until you know that you have that basic, that foundation of tune right. Now, if by some chance during the course of you making your adjustments, you find that one screw doesn't react, right? One circuit isn't reacting. The other one, one of them is carrying a lion's share of adjustment and the other one just isn't moving. Or you've got to come out like four turns before you get any result out of it. You've got a problem in the idle circuit, which is very common when carburetor has been sitting for any amount of time. Idle circuits are very finicky. We'll do a whole video on clearing idle circuits at some point. But if you've got to go more than just a turn, right, from that, you've got your initial 1.5 turns out. If you've got to go more than a turn out from that point, you've got a problem inside the carburetor. Stop at that point, go through it, clear the idle passages, and then go back. So that's it. It's really simple. It's repetition, it's practice, and it's, like I said, it's very universal. If you could make these adjustments on a simple Carter BBD, you could do it on a Holley, you could do it on an Edelbrock, you could do it on a Rochester. They're all essentially the same. No mystery, no voodoo. It's really simple stuff. I hope you got something out of that. Go out and practice on your car. Go turn those screws. But I'm telling you, no genie is going to come out the top of it. I'll see you tomorrow.